Hello friends, welcome to GYS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, as you know that your prelims is approaching and it is on 2nd June, so already approximately 40 days are left, 40 to 43 days are left. So I hope that you people are preparing at your best level, and like other tests, other institutes, we also, friends, on our channel, we have a dedicated test series for the purpose of this upcoming prelims that is on 2nd June. So what this test series is all about, so friends, it is that we are taking your 27 full length tests. And in this week we are covering your entire syllabus, whether it is ancient India, medieval India, modern India, or for that matter your we can say polity, economy, geography, science and tech, current affairs, so environment and ecology. So all topics are covered in these 27 full length tests. So today's number test number 4 of modern India. So we will be seeing the questions of the modern India. The first question is, the Woods Dispatch 1854 came to India with which of the following objectives? First, deciphering ancient Indian texts to bring out their relevance to the modern society. Second, to educate the natives of India so that a class of public servants could be created. Third, to develop practical and vocational skills of the Indians to increase production in India. Fourth, promote education free of cost in India. So friends, you have to choose the correct answer. So here the options are given before you. So here we don't share the solutions. In case you want the solutions, then you will have to subscribe to our test series, because solutions and explanations are provided only to those students who have subscribed to our test series. So you can contact us at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at our number, that is 8968426481. So this is our contact number. So in case you wish to join, you can join us. So let's move on to the second question. Second question is, Indigo or Blue Rebellion 1859 was caused due to A. harsh agri-economic conditions under which indigo cultivators were put by the British planters. B. collapse of international prices of indigo, which resulted in large-scale farmer suicide. C. indigo cultivators not receiving any loan and support from British planters. D. acquisition of cultivable indigo land by British industrial projects. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, consider the following statements. First, William Jones was the founder of Asiatic Society of Bengal and started a journal, Asiatic Researches. Second, Second is, Henry Thomas Colebrooke was associated with Royal Asiatic Society and Royal Astronomical Society. So we have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the Aligarh movement laid great stress on first, spreading modern education among Muslims. Second, reviving and promoting ancient religious practices. C, re-establishing the caste-based order in Islamic society. D, overthrowing the British government by use of agitations and not by brute force. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about non-aligned movement. So you have to consider the statements about non-aligned movement. And first is, it was established in 1961 in Belgrade as the conference of heads of state or government of non-aligned countries. Second, the movement ended after the end of Cold War. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Sixth question is, which of the following correctly show the differences in the views of Tagore and Gandhi with regards to education? First, Gandhiji was highly critical of Western civilization, whereas Tagore wanted to borrow the good elements of Western education. Second, Gandhiji was supportive of education via arts and music, whereas Tagore did not consider them crucial in education. So you have to choose which of the above statements is correct. Let's move to the next question. Next is, the demand for a constituent assembly was first made A, by the Indian National Congress in 1934, B, at Karachi session of Indian National Congress, C, after the non-cooperation movement was withdrawn, D, after the Simon Commission reached India. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, Congress split in 1907 happened on the issue of a grant of concessions to the All India Muslim League, increasingly religious tones in the Indian National Movement, and C, is methodology of struggle against the British, D, economic ideology of state-led development of India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, Indianization of British administration was the major demands of the Indian National Congress in the initial years after its establishment. So how the demand for the Indianization was seen to be beneficial for India? First, it would reduce drain of wealth from India. Second, it would lead to the gradual separation of the judiciary from the executive. And third is, it would have made a legislative council more representative. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, in the context of modern Indian history, Patuas and Comoros were A. Puppeteers and traders, B. Painters and potters, C. Agricultural labor and royal craftsmen, and your C is traders and iron ore smelters. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is Poti Sriramulu is associated with which of the following? A. 1930 Salt Satyagraha and Quit India movement, B. Linguistic reorganization of Andhra Pradesh, C. both A and B, and D is none of the above. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, which of the following are the causes behind the launch of non-cooperation movement? First, Punjab wrongs of 1919, second, Khilafat wrong, third, resentment with the royal attack. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about Lord Macaulay. First, he emphasized the need to teach vernacular languages to Indians to promote Oriental studies. Second, following Macaulay's minute, the English Education Act of 1835 was introduced. Third, he issued the order for Wood's dispatch to India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next statement. Next is, consider the following about Raja Ram Mohan Roy. First, he was keen to spread the knowledge of Western education in the country. Second, he began a campaign against the practice of sati. Third, he showed that ancient Indian texts were flawed. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, consider the following about the Ved Samaj. First, it was established in Maharashtra. Second, it was a splinter group of Brahma Samaj formed due to differences in core ideology. Third, its members believed in one god. Fourth, the Samaj showed the deeper scientific truth behind simple day-to-day rituals of Orthodox Hinduism. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is, who among the following is associated with Atmiya Sabha? A. Bal Gangadhar Tilak, B. Raja Ram Mohan Roy, C. Mahadev Govind Ranade, D. Swami Vivekanand. So let's move on to the next question. Next is, he was a nationalist and leader of the Salt Satyagraha in South India. He also served as member of the interim government of 1946 and as Free India's first Indian Governor General. So he was A. C. Raja Gopalachari, B. Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan, C. Maulana Abdul Kalam Azad, D is E.V. Ramaswamy. So from here on, friends, I will slowly scroll down, so you can pause the video, you can check the question, and you can read and you can attempt your answer appropriately. So I will not now covering 100 questions, all the 100 questions, but I will certainly cover them in the video, but I will not be dictating them. So you can see it, the 19th question. So here is complete 19 question options. So it is about Ilbert Bill. So I have again scrolled down. 20th question is here before you. So it is about Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribes, Pension of Atrocities Act 1989. So you can pause and can check the options. And this is your 21 question. Thomas Munro gradually extended the Rohitwadi system all over South India because. So here the question is about Rohitwadi settlement. Next question is, Indian National Congress made the demand for a constituent assembly only during. So this question is related to your constituent assembly and the demand relating to it. Next is, which of the following was the reason behind the Khilafat agitation in India? So you have to tell about the Khilafat agitation here, what was the most appropriate reason. Next is, the Desi movement encouraged the idea of. So here also you have to choose the correct answer, so you can pause and can reflect upon the options and can then attempt the answer. Next is, consider the following about Pune Sarvajanik Sabha. So you have to consider certain statements about Pune Sarvajanik Sabha, and you can pause and can attempt the question. Next question is, the Prarthana Samaj adhered to the tradition of Bhakti that believed in spiritual equality of all castes. And then next is, Paramhansa Mandali was founded to work for the abolition of caste. And third is, Christian missionaries of the 19th century were highly averse to breaking the caste-based traditions of India. So next is about your subsidiary alliance. So you might know that subsidiary alliance was launched by Lord Warren Hastings, I think it is I'm not able to recall the name of that person. So I think, according to my point, it is Lord Warren Hastings. So you have to choose the correct answer. So let's move on to the next question. Next is B. R. Ambedkar. Consider the following about the role of B. R. Ambedkar. So you have to choose the correct answer. And next is 29th question, and it is about Vinoba Bhave. So who led the individual satyagraha during the phase of your individual satyagraha. He was the first individual satyagrahi to be arrested, and also he was the first satyagrahi to offer this individual satyagraha when Gandhiji called upon to do so. So next is your Satnami movement. Satnami movement is in central India. So you have to tell that what it was related to. So options are given before you, so you can pause the video and can check the answer. And next is residents appointed by East India Company looked after. So here also you are given the options, so you can choose and you can pause and can reflect upon the options. Next is your Young Bengal Movement by Louis Vivian Rosio. So you have to choose the correct answer. So it was quite a revolutionary reform organization in Bengal. And next is about your Warren Hastings, that was your first Governor General. He introduced various administrative and your police reforms also. So a new system was established by him. So you have to you have to consider the statements about the new system. So there are certain statements. So this is first statement and this is your second statement. So you can choose appropriately. Next is your consider the following about Supreme Court of India. So you have to consider the first Supreme Court of India. So you have to consider these statements. And next is about your how the development of cotton industries in Britain affected textile producers in India in colonial period. So you have to choose the answer. And next is, here is the option given to you. And next is your next question is your about Theosophical Society of India. So you have to choose here also the answer, the correct answer. Next, move to the next question. Next is consider the following about permanent settlement of 1793. So statements are given before you, so you can choose appropriately. Let's move to the next question. Next is Ahom dynasty, mound burial system of Ahom dynasty. So this also you have to consider. You can pause the video. And this is your next question, doctrine of lapse of the colonial government. It was introduced by Lord Lhosey. So you can pause the video and can attempt the question. Next is Gandhiji was invited to the inauguration of the Banaras Hindu University. So he delivered a speech there. It was in fact the major public appearance of Gandhiji for the first time after he returned from South Africa. So you have to choose that what he did in this speech. So here you can pause the video. Let's move to the next question. Next is about your commercialization of agriculture, which was an important policy of we can say economic drain of India and the British economic policy. So commercialization of agriculture was an important feature of that policy, so you have to consider certain statements about it. Next is your Woods Dispatch, that was related to education. So you have to consider the statements which is whether the following is correct. And next is here, one of the most important characteristics of India's foreign policy trade throughout the colonial period was the generation of large export surplus. So you have to choose that which of the following is most appropriate reason for this. And next is here, which of the following factors could not have contributed to the Battle of Plassey. So you have to tell that which of the followings could not have contributed for the Battle of Plassey. So this is the option. Let's move on to the next question. Next is Mahatma Gandhi was opposed to separate electorates for untouchables, that is the Dalits, for which of the following reasons. So you might know the Pune Pact and all the series of events, Roundtable Conference and all those things. So if you remember, you can attempt the question. Next is your Rashtriya Ekta Divas. National Integration Day is celebrated by the government as an annual commemoration of. So here the leaders are given, you have to choose the answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is, which of the following developments of 1860s gave a boost to the Indian industries? So what was the primary reason behind it? So you have to tell the answer. So this is your options. Let's move to the next question. Next is, you have to consider certain statements about Warren Hastings. So you have to tell that which of the following is correct. And options are given before you. Let's move to the next question. Next is, Gandhi-Irwin Pact included which of the following commitments by both the parties? So you have to tell here also the appropriate answer. So there was a mistake subsidiary alliance was introduced by Warren Hastings. It was not Warren Hastings, but it was rather Lord Wellesley. Lord Wellesley. Now I am able to recall his name. Let's move on to the next question. Dandi March. So you have to consider the statements. So Dandi March, about Mr. Dandi March, the statements are given before you. Next is your Lahore session of Indian National Congress was significant for which of the following reasons? So you have to tell the reasons. And let's move on to the next question. Next is Battle of Buxar and the East India Company appointed residents in Indian states. They were. So you have to choose the correct answer about it. You can pause and can check the options properly. And this next is Gandhi listed 7 rules as essential for every satyagrahi in India. So these rules included that the satyagrahi must. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is this policy of paramountcy that British had with the princely states. So you have to tell the correct answer. Next is Khilafat movement. So you might know about Khilafat movement. So you have to tell that who was its leader, and you have to choose that what was its purpose, and whether Congress joined it or not. So this is about, next question is about your National Planning Committee, which was set up in 1938. So you have to tell which of the following is correct. So it was actually headed by Jawaharlal Nehru. So you have to choose the correct answer. Next is here, consider the following statements about your Gandhiji. So you have to tell that why, whether he followed the Gokhale's advice or not, or and in which way he forged his non-violent technique of satyagrahi and in South Africa. So you have to choose the correct answer. Next is your 1893 split in RS march. So you have to tell the reason. Next question is about your 1935 act, so, and its role that brought to the power the Congress ministries and the changes this led to. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is your Deccan Rights Commission. So it was appointed by. So you have to choose that it was appointed to, why it was appointed. So you have to tell the proper answer. This is about your civil disobedience movement, and you have to tell that what was the purpose of withdrawing civil disobedience movement. Next is about your Bardoli Satyagraha of 1928. So you can pause the video. Next question is about your Tashkent meeting that happened during the Indian freedom struggle. So why it is relevant? So you have to tell that. So next is your modern history of India about your Azamgarh proclamation. So it is associated with. So you have to choose the answers from these four options. And next is your Karachi session of Indian National Congress. So it is famously known for known for which reason. Next is your Gandhi opposed separate electorates because he believed. So separate electorates, you might know that were given to Dalits at the time of when roundtable conferences held. So why Gandhi opposed it? So you have to tell that answer. Next is the British government convened a series of roundtable conferences. So you have to choose the correct answer about RTCs also. And next is about your an individual. So certain statements are given about it, that he introduced permanent settlement in Bengal and also defeated Tipu Sultan in Anglo-Mysore War and signed treaty of Srirangapatnam. Next is about he introduced administrative and police reform. So you have to choose that which of the following is correct, and also he banned the practice of slavery. Next is about your Indian Council Act 1861, and also about your interim government. So the next question is about your August offer of 1940. So you can pause and can attempt the answer. Next is about your Constituent Assembly, which was constituted in 1946. So you have to choose that what were some important features of this assembly. So next question is Cabinet Mission. So you have to tell that what was the member of a Cabinet Mission. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Next is about your British government. And the enactments that British Parliament provided, and in which act this British Parliament got control over the administration in India. So you have to choose the correct answer. Next is your Awadhi session. So Awadhi session of Indian National Congress. So you have to tell also about it. So you have to choose the correct answer. Next is about your India ceased to be British dominion on. It is quite easy question. Next is system of diarchy introduced by the Government of India Act of 1919 meant that. So you also have to choose the answer here. Next is about your Boundary Commission headed by Radcliffe demarcated. So you have to tell that what was the purpose of Boundary Commission. Next is your Charter Act of 1833. So it brought centralization. So what it did, it is asked here. Next is about your Rampa Rebellion of 1879. So you have to choose the correct answer. So why it was there, and what was the purpose, and who led it? It is important. And next is your 80th question. 80th question is your answer the following about your Gandhiji and your Gokhale. So you have to choose just our correct answer. So you can pause the video. Next is about your Lala Lajpat Rai. So you have to consider certain statements about Lala Lajpat Rai, and you have to tell that which of the above is correct. And next question is about your third roundtable conference. So it is quite easy question. So there is also some repetition in questions. Next is your Aruna Asif Ali was associated with which of the following? So you have to choose the correct answer. Next is your Anusheelan Samiti formed in 1906 propounded. So you have to choose the correct answer that it propounded what? Next is your Wavell plan arrived at the Simla Conference in 1945 provided for which of the following? So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is about your Theosophical Society. So you have to choose the correct answer. And next is about your Malabar Rebellion. Here also you can read the statements and can choose your appropriate answer. So you have to choose the appropriate answer. And this is about your Treaty of Madras, 1769. So you have to consider certain statements about it and you have to tell that which of the following is correct. And also there is some certain recommendations of Simon Commission that came in 1927. So you have to consider those recommendations and you have to choose that which of the following is correct. And next is about your East India Company's monopoly in trade was abolished by the. So here it is asked. Next is about your Cripps mission was sent to India too. So you have to tell the purpose of Cripps mission and your next is Government of India Act 1858. So you have to tell about this also. So next is about your Mending Act of 1781 to the Regulating Act of 1773 had which of the following provisions? So you have to tell the correct answer. So you can pause the video and can tell the answer. Next is about your Minter Morley reforms of 1909. So you have to consider the purpose of those these Minter Morley reforms. And the statements are given before you. So you can pause the video. Next is about your as per the Independence Act of 1947, Governor General of India was to be. So here also you have to choose the correct answer. Next is about your as per Hastings Plan of 1972, which of the judicial reforms were introduced? Next is about your 97th question. Consider the following about Satya Shodhak Samaj. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is Governor General of India was given exclusive legislative power for entire British India by this act, and in fact the act created for the first time a government of India having authority over the entire territorial area possessed by the British in India. The act referred here was. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the next question. Next is consider the following about Budan movement started by Acharya Vinoba Bhave in 1951 from Telangana. So you have to choose the correct answer. Let's move on to the last question. Last question is what was the which movement started after the immediate partition of Bengal 1905. So this is the last question too. So this is all about your 100 full length test. So friends, in case you want to join it, if you want to get the solutions, if you want to subscribe to this whole full length test and their explanations, then you can email us to this email ID that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at our number that is 8968426481. So in case you like the questions, you like the video, then do hit a like, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel and do not forget to press the bell icon. So thank you friends, have a very nice day. Thank you very much.